Hey guys, I'm back with a video, and today I'm going to do a Transformers Generation 1 Autobot Wreck-Gar. Wreck-Gar first appeared in Transformers the Movie, the original 80s one. He's leader of the Junkions, a race of junky Transformers live on the planet Junkion. That's really kind of it, you know? There's not really much there. His alternate mode is what they call a Junk Planet motorcycle. It looks kind of like an Earth-bound motorcycle quite a bit, but it is a very nice mode. I do like it quite a bit. It is very, very simple. You can see there are his legs. Here are his arms. If he really wants to see where he's going at night, his face can flip down and just... That's kind of creepy. Kind of thing. It's a very simple alt mode, but I do like it quite a bit. He does roll rather well. He doesn't have a kickstand, at least. I don't think he does. He has a little exhaust pipe here, which, hello camera. But no kickstand, so he will just kind of prop on one side. But he does roll pretty well, surprisingly. I was actually kind of surprised at how well he does roll. He does kind of drag on the side, but still, it's a thought that counts. Sticker-wise, these are the Repro Label stickers, so they are a bit shiny still. These are brand new, and I would suggest picking those up if you don't have a Wreck-Gar in good condition. They will make him a lot spiffier. Without the stickers, he just looks very plain, very monochromic. But I do like it quite a bit. He does come with a couple of accessories. Comes with the little blaster here. It's a blaster. And he comes with this, I'm going to call a little axe here. I'm sure I'm probably wrong in my... There you go. Focus on it. So pretty cool. To transform him, it's kind of complicated in some parts, but it's really not bad. Gonna zoom out here. What you do first, you're gonna take his legs and you're gonna bring them down. They are pegged in to the, I guess, the engine block or whatever it's called. They are pegged in here. Little holes in the side, little pegs there. You're gonna separate the legs. One leg is connected to the wheel. You can see in the back here, the wheel is locked into this leg, so we're gonna go with the other leg. You're gonna unpeg it and slide the leg back. Go ahead and lock the leg in place now. Now this one with the wheel, you're gonna take the wheel and spin it around. It may kind of tug the tire occasionally. That's not really a problem. The tire will come off. It's rubber. It just pops right back on. Take this leg, bring it down with the other one. And then kind of realign these. These do move. Realign this so the tire is not being blocked at all. You can see if it's still down, the tire kind of gets you know, you can see it gets pushed up. So leave this like this where the tire fits, no problem. Easy peasy. There's this. Go to the front here. Undo his little hands and pull out the front wheel, put it aside, and you're going to take the engine portion here and you're going to swing it down. When you swing it down, you're also going to push it up. It's kind of hard to show here, but push it up and you'll be able to lock this in place. Also, when you're going back into his vehicle mode, do not force this. Give it a little pull and then also pull it down, and then you can turn this all the way up. Give a little pull again if you need to. Just remember, do not force this up. I could see this breaking over time. So again, pull it down, and then push it up. Mine likes a stick. Once that's up, go ahead and slide his arms out. Slide this front portion down, and I will get to those. Take his little face, or his head, slide it down, flip his little face out, and there you have a Wreck-Gar. You may notice, yes, he does not have his trademark mustache. I am considering on kind of sculpting one and putting on there. That could be kind of fun. But I do like this guy. The stickers look really good for his legs. It makes him kind of stand out a lot more. You can't take his weapons. You can take his little, I'm going to call it an axe. I know it's something else, but put it in hand one. Take his little gun. Pop it into hand two. And there you go. As you can tell, Wreck-Gar does have some fancy little jubblies going on here. And I think this may actually slide back more. Maybe not. This is though it could slide back more, but I honestly don't want to risk breaking it. This does feel like metal, this front portion here, so that's kind of cool to have some die cast in it. That may be it, but I don't know. It feels like metal at first, I guess. Very nice figure. Articulation-wise, the arms can move all the way around. They do get kind of stuck around his top, so they kind of bend outward. They do swing outwards. He has an elbow joint. His wrists do rotate. I was going to say do not, but they do. They just kind of get stuck occasionally. The legs can swing forward due to his transformation. You get him about that high. He has kind of reverse knees. His knees can bend like this. He can almost kick himself in the face. Almost. But the legs cannot swing backwards. The knees cannot actually bend in a proper knee bending joint type thingy. No waist movement, no head movement, unless you count that as a head movement, and that's flat out goofy. We're not going to do that. But I really do like how this looks. I'm not sure I really mentioned this. You couldn't really see it too much in the vehicle mode, but he does have a little gauge included with the stickers. Would be cool if you had some for those as well, those two front ones, but not a problem at all. I like this guy quite a bit. You can also take his wheel and stick it onto his little spinny axe of doom, and he can now roll across his enemies. Rengar was pretty cool in the movie. The Junkions themselves had a pretty cool thing. They were all pretty much the same transformer, I guess. Their alt mode, their robot mode, they're pretty much identical. So you could have a Junkion riding a Junkion in his vehicle mode. If the motorcycle got shot, it would kind of swerve off. The rider would turn into a motorcycle, and the motorcycle would turn back to the rider, and they would kind of switch each other's roles. It was really impressive. In the movie, he's actually voiced by Eric Idle of Monty Python, and in the TV version, he was voiced by Tony Pope. Not sure you guys really care about that, but it is cool. When I think Rengar, I always think Eric Idle or Weird Al now. Weird Al's kind of moved in as a new Rengar. But that's really about it. I would highly recommend picking up a Rengar. He is pretty iconic in Transformers, and he does look good in any G1 Transformers collection. I would love to see an updated version, which supposedly Fans Project may be bringing us someday. Maybe, who knows? A new Rengar in a motorcycle mode could be really nice. But that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.